Behind the plane. The voice did not belong to the old man. Riven tried to ease her breathing by exhaling slowly through her lips. There was one voice, but there could be more coming for her. She fought the years of training that urged her to take a defensive stance. Instead, she stilled her body, facing the plow and beast before her. Riven felt too light. She held on tightly, now to the plow's wooden handles. There should have been a weight that anchored her, grounded her at her side. Instead, she could hardly feel the small
strangers.
noticing her tone was more fit for calming chickens than her husband, she gave him a hopeful smile. Noxian. That is all they need to proclaim guilt, Asa mumbled, his thought into the homespun wool wrapped around his neck. Shava, who had spent the better part of her lifetime coaxing stubborn animals into the butcher's pen, stopped short, turning to face her husband. They do not know her like we know her, she said, stabbing fingers into his chest, exasperation escaping through her hands. That is why you are to speak on her behalf, you old goat. Asa knew his wife, and knew further argument would not change her mind. Instead, he nodded his head softly. Shava gave a dissatisfied harumph and turned back to the marching in silence to the town center. The council hall was beginning to fill. Seeing the crowd, she hurried into the narrow space between the benches of the council hall to find a seat closer to the front, and unceremoniously tripped over a sleeping man's leg. As the old woman fell forward with a weak yelp, a groan escaped from the sleeping man. Like a lightning blade, his hand snapped forward, his grip, like steel, catching the old woman by the arm before she fell to the stone floor. You must watch your step, Oma, the stranger whispered deferentially, drink still heavy on his breath, but slurring none of his words. He withdrew his hand as soon as the old woman was back on her feet. The old woman looked down her nose at the unlikely savior, her eyes narrowing. Under her scrutiny, the man receded further into the shadows of the mantle wrapped around his shoulders and face. The ghost of a scar across his strong nose disappeared into the darkness. The council hall is nowhere to recover from a night of misdeeds, young man. Shava righted her robes, the disdain evident in the tip of her chin. A woman's life is to be decided today. Be gone before you're asked to concede your own wrongdoings before the magistrates. Shava, the old man had caught up and put a hand on his wife's arm. You must keep your temper in check if we are to offer our assistance today. He meant no injury. Leave him be. The hooded stranger offered two fingers up in peaceful supplication, but kept his face hidden. You strike to the heart of the matter, Oma, he offered, humor creeping into his voice. Shava moved on, carrying her indignation like a delicate gift. The old man tipped his head as he passed. Do not judge her quickly, my boy. She worries that an innocent soul will be found guilty before the truth is known. The hooded man grunted in acknowledgement as the old man moved on. On that we are of the same mind, Ofa. The old man glanced back at the strange, hushed words. The seat was empty, save the ghost of a breeze that rustled the ropes of a nearby couple, deep in conversation. The hooded stranger was already receding into the far shadows of the council. Shava chose a seat at the front of the gathered crowd. this meditation hall was all the evidence that was necessary. Only one besides Suma himself could have executed such a maneuver. A wound unevenly healed opened. The hive mind of the crowd coalesced in a moment of communal pain. If the elder had not fallen, they shouted to each other, the village would not have taken such heavy casualties. Shortly after the murder, half of an Oxian war band had slaughtered many on the way to Navori. So many sons and daughters had been lost in the Noxian engagement, an engagement that swelled in the distressing imbalance of Suma's death. Worse yet, the village laid the blame on one of their own. The thrum found a clear voice. "We already know who murdered Elder Suma," Shafa spoke through weathered lips. "It was that traitor, Yasuo." Settled more easily on the bench, satisfied that the question of guilt had been pointed back at the correct person. The falcon-nosed judge came from a long line of wood weavers, once famed for being able to untwist and straighten even the heaviest pearls. She lifted a perfectly round sphere chestnut and brought it down definitively against its jet black cradle. The sharp sound wrenched the crowd into silence, and order returned to the hall. "This court seeks knowledge and enlightenment about the facts of Elder Suma's death," the judge said. "Do you wish to stand of enlightenment, mistress?" The old woman looked to her husband and felt heat rise in her skin, of her cheeks. "Conte, Shama Conte," she said much less boldly. She dipped her head. The old man on the stool watched her and mopped the sheen of sweat from his own. "As I was saying, we are here to take in new evidence." The falcon judge looked out at the crowd for any other stuff.